In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a one-piece glass door with a special mullion in Mozaik. We're also going to add a back pocket so you can insert the glass. So the first thing we're going to do to create this special mullion glass door is go into Optimizer, Libraries, CNC Tooling, Panel Tool Groups, and then Add a Group. And the whole point of this tool group is to cut out the pockets of the glass door. We're going to call this Special Mullion Glass Cutout. And to keep things simple, we're going to go on center and bring in our 3/8 compression. And think of this green line as the line on the inside of the styling rails and the special mullion. So if we offset this 3/8 compression by half the diameter, 3/16, we can select through cut and then flip side, and it will cut all of our pockets out from the back side of the door. We could go one step further and make another panel tool group to clean out the back pocket, but for now we're just going to keep it at this. I'll say okay. We're going to go back into Mozaik, to Libraries, Doors, and then the Routed tab. I'm going to add a new door, and we will call it Special Mullion Double Bow. I'll click OK. And then the first thing we have to do is left click on the panel and turn it into a glass door. I'm going to keep the 2.5-inch margins around the door. I'm going to right click on the panel, select special mullions, and we will select double bow. I'll input the mullion width as 1 inch. And this is really all we have to do for now. I'm going to edit the cabinet, go into the face tab, click on the door, and then override. I'll click on slab door. We'll select a new door style, and the door style is going to be special mullion double bow. When we override this, we'll still use cutout tool. We don't need a pocketing tool selected. We don't need a glass door panel cutout. All we need is the routed door tools. And we are going to select our special mullion glass cutout. Click OK. Click OK again. And now we have our glass door. The last step is to add a back pocket to the door. Now, there's a few different ways you can do this, but the easiest way that I'll show you is going into the Parts tab for each individual door and adding a pocket to the back. If you're familiar with using formulas, you can use formulas. I'll keep it simple, and we are going to edit the door, edit our shape, go into the Operations tab, and from here we have to make sure that we flip the door to the back side. And then I'm going to create a pocket. You can make this whatever you want. Our style and rails are 2.5, so I'll pick 2, or let's go with 2.125. And that way we have 3/8 of an inch on the back side of our door. 2.125. And then for this one, I'm going to do 19 minus 2.125. 16.875. I'm just looking at this width number right here. So whatever the width number is, we're going to subtract our number, which is 2.125, and call it good there. If you want this to scale with the cabinet, you can anchor these points. This bottom left, I will anchor to bottom and left. And then let's set these other 2 points, 2.125 on the Y. And again, we're taking 53 inches minus 2.125. And we'll do it again over here. 16.875 and 50.875. And I will anchor these. This point will be anchored top and right. This point will be anchored bottom and right. Now, the last thing we have to do with this pocket is give it a depth. I want it to go a quarter inch deep. We're going to leave the toolpath blank. If you wanted to do a clean out pass on your back pocket, you could add a toolpath in here. We're just going to select a back pocket tool. So our pocket tool, we're going to select specifically a 40 mil pocket tool. And then this is important. You want to go from the inside out and clockwise. Now, if we look at our door, we can see that we have a cutout and a back pocket. The final piece of the puzzle is going to the optimizer. We will go to cut list and optimize just like normal. Now that we're in the optimizer, I'm going to go to the parts. Looks good. We'll optimize. I want to make sure automatically flip parts is selected, and we will optimize. And it doesn't look like much now, but if we go into the 3D viewer, we can see what it's going to look like. Now, to test out what this G code is going to do, we're going to generate G code, calculate, and line by line, check it out. We have 40 mil pocket on the back, a 3/8 compression, and then a 3/8 compression during the cutout of the door. Of course, after this 3/8 compression is done, you'll have to take a pole saw or a chisel and sharpen up these corners, but this will get you 99% of the way. All right, so I wanted to show you one more trick with these special mullion doors. Now that we've made the glass door with the back pocket, we can actually edit this cabinet again. Go to the face tab, click on the door, override, and we're able to right click and actually change the special mullion again. If you click on double bow, you can change the mullion size. Or you can right click special mullions and pick something else. The nice thing is that as long as we don't rebuild this door face, we can go into the parts, look at our door, edit the operations, and you'll see that the back pocket is still there. And we can also resize this cabinet or save it to our library. As long as you used anchor points for all four points in the corners, it will hold its form. And the last tip I have for you is in the optimizer, some of you may have vacuum issues when trying to cut a door with such small mullion sizes. So what we can do is actually, without re-optimizing, we can change the panel tool group so that it does not cut through. It actually leaves a very small onion skin. And how we're going to do that is going back up to libraries, CNC tooling, panel tool groups. We'll go back to our special mullion glass cutout. And instead of through cut, we're going to assume you're using 3/4 MDF. And we can type in 0.73 or 0.735. Now that's going to leave about 1/64 of material to hold everything together so your vacuum can stay intact. And you'll go in later and use a utility knife or something sharp to cut out the onion skin. And as you can see in this 3D, it's no longer cutting through, but it's leaving a little skin for you. This video was able to help some of you out. If you liked it, go ahead and like and subscribe down below. If you have any questions, leave your comments below as well. Thank you.